Hi everybody, today you're going to be watching a few microlearning videos all about Workspace. Workspace is exactly what it sounds like. It's a working space for students. So what you're seeing in front of you is a very basic workspace that includes a variety of learning activities, goals, and you can also include rubrics or other forms of assessment. It's a one-stop shop for students, so that they can access all of the content necessary for their learning. To start creating a workspace, you're going to go to our staff portal. You're going to click on the second icon. You can even narrow it down by actually clicking the word workspace. It's going to take you to this screen, which is sort of like a place where everything is housed. So here is where all of your workspaces that you create will be found. So right now I'm in the section owned by me, but you can also narrow it down by looking at workspaces that have been shared with you or professional learning workspaces as well. But today we just have this landing page, and now we're going to go up to the top right-hand corner where it says create. Here is where you're going to add a title, and you're going to associate it to one of your classes. These classes are pulled from PowerSchool. And then you hit create. You don't need to create your own groups here or write a description. All of that can happen after. So for right now, when you create a workspace, put a title and associate it to one of your classes and hit create. Here is your workspace. This is where you as the teacher get to design and create and input a variety of different learning activities for your students. You have four columns to work with. These columns can be renamed by clicking and editing. You can rename it to use the language that you use in your class. Maybe you're a French teacher, or maybe you use different language with your students when you're talking about goals. For example, if you're a primary teacher, maybe you use I can statements. If you don't put something into one of these four columns, the students will not see anything. So you don't have to use all four columns. This is just what you have to work with as the teacher. The one thing to remember, and we're going to get to this in another one of our learning videos, is the third column is formatted differently than columns 1, 2, and 4. So anything that you want the students to do has to go into column 3. Columns 1, 2, and 4 are essentially view-only columns. They would not be able to edit anything in those columns. If you go over to the left-hand side in your workspace, these two chevrons give you a different set of options that you can manipulate. We're going to talk in a little bit later about students and groups, but right now, if you are new to Workspace, we want you to toggle off students can add cards. That can come once you start using Workspace and become a little bit more comfortable with the platform. But essentially, you're not allowing students to add their own cards in. So you're going to toggle that off if you are new to Workspace. Once you start adding in your goals, maybe some resources, and of course the learning activities, we can even change that to use to say learning activities. You want to make sure that once your workspace has a few things in it, that you hit publish. Once you hit publish, it's then going to be able to be viewed and accessed by your students. Until you hit that publish button, your students can't see anything. Don't be afraid to hit publish early, even if there's only one or two things in there. It's a live tool, meaning that as soon as you add something as the teacher, your students are going to be able to see it. So it's something that you can build over time and structure it in a way that's accessible for your students. And what I mean by that is at the very bottom, you do have the option to add sections, which means that this is going to break up your content horizontally. So you can add a section. Maybe this says week one. And now you can actually build underneath that week one. Our one recommendation is that you put the newest information at the top. If you think about social media like Twitter or Instagram, the newest information is always first. So you want to build up You don't want to build down with your new information. The next video up is going to be talking all about what kinds of learning activities you can put into a workspace.